Very good morning, my dear students. Today I'm going to discuss with another video with another topic, and the topic today which I have taken today, that is resonance. On looking the heading, you might be wondering that what is resonance and why is the resonance. That all I will discuss in this today's video. Okay, so let's just get started with the very first molecule which I'm going to take, that is ozone. Before that I have to explain with this structure. If I'm drawing the structure, Lewis dot structure of ozone, it is quite clear that now you people are expert in drawing the ozone or any Lewis dot structure, as I hope. Yes, there will be one double bond and one coordinate bond will be there. So okay, before that, I just want to tell you that what is resonance. Resonance is just shifting of pi electrons. Okay, shifting of pi electrons, or we can say that, or lone pair of electrons, or lone pair of electrons. Got it? This is the important thing that you have to keep in your mind. Okay, now, so whenever this pi bond shift, it can, like, this is the shifting can be explained by this way, that the pi bond will shift in negative charge, can be converted into negative form, or it can be converted into electronic form, or the electron, when the lone pair of electrons shift, it can form the pi bond over there, or the negative charge, if shifts, it can also form the pi bond over there. So let me explain then when it happens. Okay, so in this resonance topic, actually we are supposed to draw some very simple example in this resonance, but in this resonance only I will discuss all about that resonating structure which we will do in our hydrocarbon chapter in our GOC, okay, general organic chemistry. So there the resonance is again a big topic, a very important topic, so that also we will discuss here only. Okay, so let's start with this ozone. If I'm drawing the structure like this, so it is quite clear that here it is forming double bond and here it is forming single bond, coordinate bond. Okay, so see, the coordinate bond and the covalent bond, what are this single bond? Let me explain this thing, that if suppose that X and Y molecule is there, okay, so one of X and one of Y, if they participate with each other, then it is forming covalent bond XY, and that is called covalent bond. Okay, what when both the X is donating this electron to this, then it forms X coordinate bond, and this is called coordinate bond. But you cannot separate the coordinate bond or the covalent bond after the bond formation. Once looking on that, you cannot say that whether it is covalent or coordinate. So it will be a simple, like, before the bond formation, you can say that if it is equal sharing, it is the covalent bond, and if it is unequal sharing, you can say that it is a coordinate bond. But after the bond formation, we cannot separate like that. Here to explain, to present, we have drawn like this. But in general, if you observe this spectroscopy and all that, we will not be able to identify this. Got it here? Okay. So now we can say that this coordinate bond is just like a covalent bond. Any problem in this? No. Okay. So let's do what it is. Here the shifting of pi electron we have to do. Clear? So in this case, what's the need of resonance? First, let me tell you that what's the need of resonance. So if this is spectroscopy and all that we checked, then we got that this is the double bond, yani ki bond order is more. Okay, so and the bond length should be shorter. So bond length should be around 120 picometer aspas. Okay, got it. And this is the single bond, so it is around 150 picometer, like that. Okay. But when this experimentally observed, then it is found that the bond length is neither be 120 nor 150. So it was some around 130. Got it? So how it possible? That means then the scientists to work upon that, and lots of theory, lots of research they have done, and after that they assume that might be this bond length or the bond enthalpy and all that cannot be explained by one single Lewis dot structure. So then they thought of this, lots of thinking process were there, and then they came to point that might be they are making different structure, they are showing the different structure for the same molecular formula. Okay, so what next? And from there the resonance came in the existence. Okay, so what it is not exact value, I'm not talking about the exact value, it is just approximate value I have taken. Okay, so in this case it is said that if I'm shifting this bond, so as I said that this bond is going to shift over here and this will shift over here, so this is the double-sided arrow which shows the resonance. Okay, so this will be like given, if I'm making the structure like this, it will be like this. Okay, but neither this structure is correct nor this structure is correct. Actually the structure which is correct is that double bond is delocalizing. Sometime it is in between this molecule, sometime between in this molecule. So what I will say, this bond is not going to break. Okay, and this double bond is delocalizing. So I will show double bond dotted line. Clear? And then it was observed that the bond length which was supposed to be for the double bond 120 and for the single bond 150, now it is some around 130. Okay, so that means it is neither equal to the double bond nor equal to the single bond. Got it? So these two structures which we have drawn, that is called canonical structure. Okay, and finally whatever the structure we have drawn, that is called resonance hybrid. So actually none of the canonical structure is correct structure. The correct structure is only the resonance hybrid. I hope it is clear. Yes, no issue with that. Okay, so let's start with another example, and for this I'm taking another example like carbonate. This was for the ozone molecule. Okay, first example I have taken for the ozone molecule. Now I'm going to take for the carbonate, that is CO3-2. So if you will draw the Lewis dot structure of this carbonate, we will get some picture like this. This is double bond O and O-, isn't it? Now you people are very expert in drawing this Lewis dot structure as, can I assume this? Yes. Okay. So let's move. So this is, now what I said, I will give you the short trick for that also. But before that, let me show the bond, how the bond is shifting, how the shifting of pi bond, pi electron is occurring over there. Okay, pi bond or pi electron you can say. So in this case, see, there is a pi bond and there is a negative charge. Both are electron density. They both are, if we talk about this minus charge, that means it also shows the electron density, high electron density. And if we talk about the double bond, that also shows the high electron density. Got it? Both are having high electron density. So if the high electron density is there, then what will happen? They will so both are having high electron density. Got it? That negative charge as well as double bond. So that means if any part, anywhere, if the electron density is quite high, then what it will do? It will revolve, it will donate. Okay, acha, one more thing I'm just going to tell you. Whenever electron moves, they release some energy. Got it? Important point. If electrons or the pi bond moves, they release energy. Okay? So, can I say that more number of electrons movement, more will be the release of energy? Isn't it? Yes. More movement of electron, more energy release, and we know that the substance get stabilized by releasing energy. If this is the thermodynamic law, Yes, by losing the energy, the molecule, the substance get stabilization. So we can say that on more electron movement, more energy release, so more will be the stabilization. Stabilization, yes or no? Clear? And this is known as, the electron movement is known as what? Resonance. So can we say that more resonance, more stabilization? Yes or no? Yes, that is quite clear. So from there we got the fact that if a molecule is having more number of resonating structure, that will be more stable. Clear? No issue? Okay. So I have drawn for this carbonate and I was telling about the electron density. So both are having more electron density. That means it will tend to move. It will try to lose the energy. It will try to release the energy, and release energy kinetically, that electron will move. Got it? So either this negative charge will move or this double bond will move. So if we compare this negative charge and double bond, so this one is somewhat bonded, but this one is free. So which one will have like more tendency to move? Obviously the free one, yes, because of course electron density is quite high, but still with comparison to this, it is little bonded. So that's why the movement is not possible in such a frequency which is possible in this case. Got it? So what will happen? The first negative charge will move. So this negative charge will move on which side? It is going to move on this bond. So I have told you that negative charge, if it is going to move, it will form the double bond. Yes? Okay. So wait, we will do. So as this negative charge is shifting over here, this is going to rise a 5 bond over here. One more bond will form. And 2, 3, 4, already 4 bond were there. One more bond will form. So this carbon will be unstable because of 5 bond. So at the same time, what will happen? This bond will shift to this oxygen. Clear? Any problem? This curve arrow notation should be very much clear. This is the concept. I will tell you the short method also, but first the concept should be clear. Okay. So what will happen? The more electron denser electron will move first, due to which it will form a double bond over here. The carbon will have 5 bonds, and that's why to make it stable again, this bond will break on the oxygen side. So what will be the resonating structure, if that canonical structure or the resonating structure, if I will draw for this, it will give you like this. See, and here this is double bond. This negative charge will shift over here and it will form double bond. I have not touched this. So it will remain like this. No issue. And here it will be O minus. Any problem? Clear? Okay. So now we have, like in the movement, we have used this too. Yes? इस नेगेटिव को मूव कर लिया, ये नेगेटिव मूव नहीं हुआ. सो नाउ इन नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल ट्राई टू मूव दिस नेगेटिव ऑन दिस. एज दिस नेगेटिव विल मूव ओवर हियर, द कार्बन विल हैव अगेन द 5 बॉन्ड्स, एंड टू गेट द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस कार्बन, दिस डबल बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट ऑन द ऑक्सीजन. इज इट क्लियर? इट इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट. यू शुड बी वेरी क्लियर विद दिस. ओके. सो इफ आई एम डूइंग लाइक दिस, व्हाट इट विल गिव, इट विल राइज इन दिस, दैट सी I have not touched this bond, so it will remain like this. Yes, and here it will be O minus, and here it will form double bond. Any problem in this? Quite clear? Yes? Samajh mein aa gaya? So this is called, and now you see that if I will move again, if any one of this is going to move again, the first structure we are going to get it back, isn't it? The first structure we will get, like suppose that if I am moving this negative charge over here, then this bond will come over here, here double bond, and here negative charge. That means we are going to get the first structure. So that's it. The movement we have done. The resonance we have completed. Yes? So this is the first structure. This is the second structure. Or let it be, this is the first structure. This is the second structure. And this is the third structure. So first, second, and third, these are the canonical structure. What is this? This is called canonical structure. Any problem in this? Quite clear? So, but as I told you that all these canonical structure are like hypothetical. None of this is original. None of this is true. Okay. So what we will do? We will draw the resonance hybrid, which is the only actual structure. So if I will draw the resonance that we can draw in this way, like equivalence sign. Okay. This is the, or you can say that the triple, like this also. This is the equivalence sign. So what will happen? I will draw like C, O, O and O. The single bond is not going to break in between this. It will remain like that, isn't it? But this double bond is going to shift everywhere. So what I will do? I will draw a dotted line this like this. And will not put the negative charge, because negative charge, I don't know on which oxygen is this. So as a overall, we will put negative charge. And this is called the resonance hybrid, which is having the most stable structure, or more stability than any canonical structure. Okay, resonance hybrid. What we will say? Most stable than any canonical structure. I hope it is clear. No issue. Yes. Okay. So let's do another thing, another structure, and we will do for nitrate ion. So can I assume that you people can draw the nitrate structure very easily? Yes. Actually, let's do this third structure if I am drawing. This is NO3 minus. So this is going to be N oxygen 3. So let it be like this. Yes. And okay, some question can also be asked that out of this canonical structure, which one is the stable one? Okay, so that also we will discuss in later on part, like last part of this resonance topic. So all the questions, all the PYQs we will solve, all the difficult questions, level questions we will solve. Okay, so by the time just we will focus on this NCERT part and that the basic part of the resonance. So this is NO3 minus. If it is one, like let me, this is one with the double bond. Here one will be the single bond, and here is like this. Okay. So with one, I have to make this negative charge. Clear? Koi dikkat nahi? Quite clear. You are so expert now in drawing the Lewis dot structure. So okay, what next we will do? Again the same thing. We will assume it as a covalent bond. Nothing like a special treatment for this coordinate. Okay. So, okay, now what will happen? Same electron density is here also, more here also. So, this negative charge is going to move. So, this will move, and hence the nitrogen will have the 5 bond. So, the double bond will shift on the oxygen above. Yes, like this. So, what will be the structure? This is not going to list. This is going to be O minus, and here it is double bond. I have not touched and with this, so it will remain like that. What next? This will again move over here. Yes, so in this case this bond will come over here, and we are going to get the first structure back. So this is the resonance canonical structure for this. Okay, one thing, this double bond can be like, I can shift over here na, isko main aise bhi dikha sakti hu that the coordinate bond with this and the double bond with this, there is no problem at all. This can also be drawn, isn't it? Yes. So shifting is not possible in this case, but if we shift this, we are going to get the first one with. But these three are the canonical structure. This is canonical structure. Okay. A short trick also I am going to tell you. Just let me complete this and then. Okay. I think it is clear. No issue with this. Yes. So if I will draw the resonance hybrid, let me, okay, this is the resonance hybrid. So I should put the triple bond over here. Three lines. Okay, so now the resonance, if I'll draw, it will be like somewhat N O O O, and the single bond is not going to do anywhere, like it is not going anywhere, and this is the delocalization of pi electron, and here is a minus one charge like this. So this is resonance hybrid, which is the stable one. Okay, let me do the short trick for these type of molecule, this type of polyatomic ion. We are not going to consider about any compound. Later on part we will do that, but here for this short trick, what can be the trick? So it's very simple, nothing to do with this. What you have to draw, like this is the like alternative way I'm going to write over here. Alternative way. Okay, if you are not so confident about the shifting of bond and all, so you can make it like that. No issue. यहाँ तो इसमें वैसे भी इसमें in the ozone there is no problem at all. So I have drawn like this. What next? See, in this resonance, the molecule there will be no rearrangement of elements. It will only be the shifting of electrons. Clear? समझ में आई बात? Atom is or the molecule is not going to change its place. Only the shifting of pi electron will be there or the lone pair of electron will be there. Okay, so what we'll do in this case, this is not going to change, but here it is double bond. So now this time we will put the double bond over here and this A will come over here. That is the only canonical structure. Got it? Similarly, let's do for the carbonate. Alternative way. This is carbon. Here oxygen. This is the original structure I have given. Yes. Now what to do? Nothing like this. This double bond which come this time and just try to rotate this bond in the anti-clockwise direction. Always start with the anti-clockwise direction or rotate karte raho till you are getting the first structure. By that time just rotate it. Okay, so let's rotate this double bond will shift over here and this negative will come over here, this negative will go over here. Yes, so this is O minus, this will double bond and this is O minus. Any problem? Now this double bond will shift over here and this negative will over here and this negative will over here. So this is another structure. This is double bond over here and this one is going to over there and this one is going to over come over here. Okay, so we got the first structure. No, still not. Now next thing, if I'm going to shift over here, yes, if I'm going to shift over here, this will come over here and this will come over here. So we will get exactly this structure. So these are the canonical structure. That is the alternative way. Similarly, if I'm going to, for this, what you will do? This is N double bond O, this is O minus and this is coordinate bond O. So in next case, what anti-clockwise, this double bond will shift over here, this negative charge will come over here and this coordinate bond will go over here. So make the structure, this is the coordinate bond and here the double bond and here is the O negative. Again, this double bond will come over here, this negative will come over there and coordinate will come over here. So next structure, let me this double bond O, this is the negative O and here the coordinate bond O. Again, move the same way, if it is going up, this negative is will come over here and this dative bond will come over here, the same structure we will get. So that's why this is the canonical structure. Any problem? Yes, let's do with. Now next compound I am going to do with this NO2, that is the odd electron molecule. If I will say fourth, this is the NO2, fourth, okay, so let me do this. If I will draw the structure, this is NO2 over here and then this will be odd electron molecule over here and this is going to make oxygen over here. Yes, coordinate bond. Clear? Any problem? So the simple, the shift that, yes, this coordinate bond will come over here and this double bond will go over here. There will be no other change. So like this, these two are the canonical structure. Okay. Okay, in your NCERT, there is a question for this, like H3PO4, fifth, if I, there's the canonical structure they have drawn for H3PO2, okay, let me draw this. This is OH, this is double bond O, OH, and this is H. The structure of H3PO3. And another structure they have drawn this, HOPOH and OH. So it is asked that, are they the canonical structure? Are they canonical structure or resonance hybrid? Okay, so simple si baat hai, no. Why? Because in the beginning only I have told you that resonance means transfer of electrons only, not the shifting of atoms. atom will not shift. Like check karo, this OH is going to be here same, this OH is same over here, but in this case this P is directly attached to H and O, but in this case the shifting of oxygen is there, which is not possible. So no, they are not canonical structure. Got it? Okay. Now let us do for more few more example. Like in this case, I am going to give you this CH2 double bond CH C double bond OH. Okay. So in this case, we have only double bond, which have more electron density. So what we will do is we will shift this. So let's do this. Okay, so let's start with this shifting of bond over here, because nothing else is there to shift. Okay, so now the double bond has to shift, but there are the two type of double bond. One double bond is between carbon and carbon, and another double bond is between carbon and oxygen. Clear, bache? So in which case the double bond is more prominent to move? Sure, quite clear that this one, because of more electronegative, so this will try to tend try to attract the electron from towards itself. Yes, so that's why this bond will be broken first. Yes, so if this bond shift over here, so what it will result, one bond shifting, and we will write the result. So we'll show the result by this way, that nothing changes over here, so let it be like this. Done. Yes. And this will result in this plus charge over here, and here O minus and H. Clear? So another thing kya hoga, this has the electron deficiency. So this bond will shift, bond to bond shifting will be there. This will be called bond to bond shifting. Okay. And why it will shift? Bond shifting. To complete the octet of this. Although this is going to be like under octet, but it will do. Got it? So what will happen? This is the last one, and this is CH2. Since it has lost its electron, so it will have positive charge over here, and this is CH double bond CO minus H. Now no more movement is possible. This is the resonating structure. So we will say that this is the first structure, and this is the second structure, and this is the third structure. So if it will be asked that draw the resonating structure or draw the canonical structure. Resonating structure and canonical structure both are same thing. So if it is said like this, then you have to draw like this. Okay. Another question which can be asked from this topic, that out of first, second and third, which one is more stable? So here the question will be there. Out of first, second and third, which one will be more stable? So for this, I'm going to tell you a rule there, and along with this examples, I will give you the six trick for that, to get the more stable or acidic and basic character we will identify by this. So by these trick. Okay. So for this trick, there is a first trick, that structure. Let me write over here the trick number one. Structure having no charge separation is more stable than the structure having charge separation. Got it? So now you can easily tell me that out of first, second, third, which one is more stable? Yes. So the trick number one is this, and easily you can say that structure one is more stable. So structure one is more stable than structure two and three. Clear? Because there is no charge separation, while in this case there is a charge separation. That means plus minus charge are there. So that's why you can say that there is a charge separation. So that's why it will be like first will be more separation because there are no charge separation. Okay. Now another thing, if another question I am giving you, that is the suppose seventh question I will give you, that draw the resonating structure of this CH3 single bond CO CH2 minus. Okay, draw the resonating structure. So for the resonating structure, what we have to do, we know that double bond is there, negative charge is there, so electron density is more in both the case. So which will move first, electron negative charge, because it is free, while this double bond is still, the electron density is bonded over here. So that's why it is not free, it is not that much free to move, but this will move. So if this moves over here, what will happen? This carbon will have 5 bonds, so immediately this will shift over here. Read out. Okay, so the structure will be like this, CH3, CNO minus, and this will be form CH2. Koi dikkat? Clear hai? And another thing, agar, suppose that, I don't know that I am not going to discuss about this negative charge and electron density more zyada concept. So let it be that it is double bond. If it is happening that this bond, let me draw the structure again. CH3, C double bond O, CH2. And minus. Okay, suppose that if it no need to draw the structure, in this only we can see. So this is the structure 1 and this is the structure 2. First the question is that draw the resonating structure, I have drawn. And the second thing, out of first and second which one is more stable? More stable. So there I'm going to give you trick number 2. And trick number 2 is negative charge on more electronegative and positive charge on less electronegative negative along with octet completion is more stable than negative charge, than opposite, like negative charge on less electronegative and positive charge on more electronegative. Ye quite clear samajh mein aayi baat? On more electronegative. It simply says that the less negative electronegative element should have the plus charge and the more electronegative element should have the negative charge. That is the stable condition. And along with this, the octet completion should also be there. Then also that one is more stable than this case. So now in this case, check karo. If you talk about this, okay, so this is the rule, okay. Now check this structure 1 and structure 2. In this case, the carbon is having negative charge, while in this case, the oxygen is having negative charge. Carbon is less electronegative, but still it is having negative charge. And oxygen is more electronegative and have negative charge. So oxygen is that much capable to take the negative charge because it is more electronegative, yes. But if I'm talking about this, so it will not take because carbon is less electronegative and it is still carrying the negative charge, which carbon will not be handled. So in this case, the case 1 is less stable than case 2. Yes or no? Another thing, you just check this octet completion. If I am coming over here, in this case, the oxygen is octet to yahan pe bhi complete tha, yahan pe bhi complete hai sabke. Theek hai, koi dikkat nahi hai. Okay. So according to this negative charge wala concept, that structure 2 is, we'll say that structure 2 is more stable than the structure 1. Any doubt? Yes? Clear, bachi? One more example I'm giving you for this. Like example 8. If it is... First draw the resonating structure and then tell me which one will be the more stable. Like this is NH2 and here it is double bond. And here it is OH, sorry, lone pair, and here it is OH. Okay. And here it is double. So this is the structure. Draw the resonating structure. Now here is the double bond, here is the double bond, and here is the electron. So in this 3 case, we know that the electron density is high. That means in तीनों में से कोई ना कोई मूव करेगा. सो नाउ इफ यू चेक दैट दिस बॉन्ड इज बॉन्डेड, दिस इज ऑल्सो बॉन्डेड, बट दिस वन इज फ्री. सो विच वन विल मूव फर्स्ट? दिस वन विल मूव फर्स्ट. सो इफ इट मूव्स ओवर हियर ऑन दिस बॉन्ड, व्हाट विल हैपन? दिस विल शिफ्ट ओवर हियर. क्लियर है? कोई दिक्कत? समझ में आ रही बार? और विल डू वन सेकेंड. दिस बॉन्ड टू बॉन्ड शिफ्टिंग करते हैं. दिस विल ओवर हियर एंड ड्यू टू विच द डबल बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट ओवर हियर. ओके, सो लेट्स ड्रॉ द स्ट्रक्चर. क्या बनेगा? ऑक्सीजन हैज लॉस्ट इट्स इलेक्ट्रॉन ओवर हियर, सो दैट्स लाइक द बॉन्ड इज शिफ्टेड टुवर्ड्स इट, सो दैट मींस इट विल हैव माइनस चार्ज. यस, क्लियर? एंड दिस बॉन्ड हैज शिफ्टेड ओवर हियर, सो नाउ इट इज डबल बॉन्डेड ओवर हियर. एंड हियर ऑल्सो दिस लोन पेयर शिफ्टेड ओवर हियर, सो इट इज गोइंग टू मेक द डबल बॉन्ड ओवर हियर लाइक दिस. इफ यू चेक द ऑक्टेट, सो एवरीवेयर दिस ऑक्टेट इज कंप्लीट. यस, this nitrogen octet is complete, is everyone's octet is complete. Now structure 1 and structure 2, this is structure 1 and this is structure 2, which one is more stable? So tell me fast. In this case, nitrogen, and nitrogen has lost its electron, so it will have positive charge over here. Okay, earlier the positive charge were here. Okay, so in the structure 1 we can see that the oxygen is having positive charge, while in this second case nitrogen is having positive charge. This bond shift over here, so one second, here no charge will be then. It shifts, so yahan iske lone pair aa jayenge, do lone pair will be like this. Okay, no negative charge, only that lone pair. Is it clear? The structure was like this. I have forgot to put this plus charge over here. This bond, this electron shifted over here, due to which double bond carbon will have 5, so this bond will shift over here and this double bond will shift over oxygen, jisko electron deficiency thi, so now it is going to complete. So oxygen will get both the lone pair of electrons. Yes, clear? So in this case, now structure 1 and structure 2, which one is more stable? Can you tell me? In this case, the oxygen is having positive charge, while in this case, the nitrogen is having positive charge. So out of oxygen and nitrogen, which one is less electronegative? Nitrogen, isn't it? So that means nitrogen can accommodate positive charge, but oxygen, no. A big no. Yes, because oxygen is more electronegative than the nitrogen, so it cannot handle the positive charge over itself. Yes, so that's why we can say that structure 2 is more stable than structure 1 and the concept above. Yes, clear? Any problem? Let's do some more example. Like if I'm giving you this question. Question number, this is 8, and next I'm going to do with this 9th number. For this 9th, I'm giving you the structure like CH3, C double bond O over lone pair here, and this is having plus charge. Okay, so draw the resonating structure for this. What we will do, this lone pair, because here it cannot move na, because it is positive charge, electron deficiency. So it has to complete its octet. What will happen? This lone pair will shift over here, and due to which this CH3 and this C, and here it will form triple bond oxygen positive charge. Clear? Because oxygen has lost its one electron. Okay. Now in this case, if I'm giving you a structure 1 and a structure 2, what will be the, which one will be the more stable? Tell me. Ab yahan pe dekho. There is one rule I have explained. Negative charge on more electronegative, positive charge on less electronegative with complete octet, isn't it? But agar hum yahan pe dekhte hain, if we see that, this carbon is deficiency, that means here it is 6 electron only. But in this case, everywhere it's 8 electron. Okay, तो अब यहाँ पे क्या है, अगर हम ये देखते हैं कि with this charge if we check, the carbon is having positive charge and oxygen is having positive charge, so carbon is less electronegative, so can accommodate this positive charge. So according to this, the structure 1 should be more stable than the structure 2. But अगर हम octet देखते हैं, तो octet is not completed. So here is another rule that if both the rule of electronegativity, that above rule, if both the electronegativity and the electronegativity and octet rule contradicts each other, then octet rule will get more priority. So we will check that which one is having more, like 8 electrons, whether this electronegativity wala concept clear ho ya na ho wahan pe. So if we check that in this case it is 8 electron, but it is the 6 electron, although the oxygen is having positive charge over here, but still the structure 2 will be more stable than the structure 1, and the reason I have mentioned because octet rule will get more priority. This is the trick number 3. Any problem in this? Clear hai bachche? Theek hai? Okay, few more examples let's do with this. Agar like 10th question, if I am giving you that there is OH with the lone pair here, and this is CH plus, and there is NH2 lone pair over here. Okay, draw the resonating structure first. So if I will draw the resonating structure, this oxygen and nitrogen, which will give the electron? Oxygen is more electronegative, so it has a tendency to attract the electron, not to give, so will not be better living, a better donor group. So nitrogen will give, yes, over here. So if nitrogen gives, the resonating structure will be somewhat like this. OH, no change with this, then CH, now here it will be double bond, and NH2 with the positive charge. Okay, so in this case the carbon is having positive charge, but in this case the nitrogen is having positive charge. Nitrogen is more electronegative than the carbon, but still we will decide that structure 1 or structure 2, which one is more stable, structure 1 and structure 2. Acha chalo ek aur agar hum de dete, suppose that in oxygen ne diya, if oxygen has donated, agar by chance oxygen has donated agar diya hota, to there will be the third resonating structure, and that will be like OH plus charge, this is CH, here double bond ho jayega, CH, and this is NH2. So this is structure 3. Now arrange all these three structure in increasing order of stability. So what we will do, this is structure 1, here we can see that this is 6 state, 6 electron over here, isn't it? But in other cases 8 electron. So that means ab yahan pe agar electronegativity and octet rule, to obviously octet rule is going to be lead, so that means it structure 1 will have the least stability, yes. So increasing order the structure 1 will have the least one because it is having 6 electron. Quite clear ho gaya. Now there is a competition between structure 2 and structure 3, which one is more stable. So check this, ab here the 8 electron, so we will not use this. So yani ki that electronegativity wala concept we will add. So here oxygen is more electronegative than the nitrogen, isn't it? And oxygen is carrying positive charge over here, so that means the structure 3 is not that much stable as the structure 2, yes. So what we'll say, structure 3 and then structure 2. I hope it is clear. Yes, clear hai? The same concept lagega yahan pe. Any doubt in this? Quite clear? Okay, so next thing, draw for this. There are the three more rules, and that is somewhat like it is related, like different relation with this. So we'll do afterwards. A few more resonating structure we have to draw, we have to learn about that, and then I will explain all that three tricks. Okay, so let's start with the benzene ring. If there is a benzene ring, how you will draw the canonical structure and the resonance hybrid. So nothing else, all the three bonds are only there, all the pi bonds are there, so electron density, kisi bhi ek bond ko aap move kara sakte ho. So just always follow the anti-clockwise movement, okay? So it is just for convention, taki aapko dimag mein, you will not be confused ki kaun sa move kara rahe. Hamesha anti-clockwise direction mein move karo. So, or you can use the clockwise, but ek direction ko follow rakhoge, okay? So I am going to use this anti-clockwise direction. So this bond is going to shift over here. Bond is going to break. So as a result, this will give you the canonical structure. No change with this bond. So will remain like this. No change with this bond will remain like this. Yahan pe ye bond break hua. So this bond has broken on this side. So that means this will have the negative charge and this will have the positive charge. Any problem? Now we have negative charge and bond, so we know that which will move. Obviously the negative charge will move, aur ye tab tak movement chalta rahega until we are getting the this structure back pe wapas na hum pahunch jaye. So now this will shift, this negative is going to shift over here. So carbon will have 5 bonds, so this bond will break on the next, exactly next carbon. So what next? This is here, it will go over here, so it will make the double bond over here. I have not touched this, so it will remain like this. This I have not touched, so it will remain like this. Yes, and what happened? Ye bond ab yahan pe shift ho gaya, so this will have the negative part over here. Clear? Any problem in this? This will have negative part over here. Now next, again this negative will move further, so due to this, this bond will move on this next, and what will happen? We will get the structure like this. I have not touched with this, so just as it is, this negative is going to make the bond over here, double bond, and this bond is going to break over here, so it will create the negative charge over here. In next case, what it will happen, this plus minus is going to make a bond over here and it will give you this. So how many canonical structure we got 5 canonical structure, 5 canonical or resonating hybrid, resonating structure bhi keh sakte, 5 canonical structure we got. So what will be the resonance hybrid? If we draw the resonance hybrid, we will get somewhat like this. This is not going to change, but double bond is delocalizing over here, so we will delocalize like this, and in the anti-clockwise direction we will show the direction. So this is resonance hybrid. Okay, out of this 5 canonical structure, the 3 are called Kekulé structure, 3 and Dewar structure. So let me draw this. If I am drawing this, it is like this, the one first one and the fifth one. What is the difference between first and fifth? You can see one or two bond hum yahan pe kar rahe, so we are shifting like this. Yahan pe one or two, this is fifth bond, 3, 4, 5th and 6th. Here the bond is between 1 and 6, but here is the bond is in between 1 and 2. So that is the difference. So let me draw this 2 structure over here. And these 3 structures like this, we will write, we will make the double like bond over here or here. And in between, we will draw the like wall like a structure. Similarly, in this case, now the bond will be on this side, and here it will be like this. And another third case, the bond will be like here, and then we'll draw. So these 3 are known as Dewar structure. Dewar was the scientist, but to learn we can say Dewar. there is a divar between this. Yes, so that's why we can say divar structure, and these two are called Kekule structure. This is the name of scientist, okay? Kekule structure. So this is the very famous aromatic compound, and it is benzene. Without this, there is no organic chemistry. Okay? तो हमें ये याद रखना है. Got it, dear? Any doubt? Okay? Another, if I am giving you like another example to draw, lots of example there. This is the last example. Next, we will do in the next class. So if I am giving you like what will happen? The positive charge is there, electron deficiency. So this is not going to move. Yes, the double bond will move. What will happen? If this double bond is going to move over here to complete its deficiency, so this double bond will shift over here. And what we will get? Now the structure we will get like this bond has shifted over here and this bond has shifted over here. So we got the positive charge over here. Any problem? Clear? Okay. Now next thing, as I said that anti-clockwise direction ko move karo, so it will be better ki agar aap isko move karte. Anyhow, we can draw like, let me draw. We can draw like this also. And this bond will shift over here. Okay. So just cut it. We will do again. So what it will form, this will give the structure like this here, and this bond has shifted over here, so that's why. But here now positive charge, isn't it? It's positive charge. So now this bond will shift over here. Yes, so it will result in this structure, double bond over here, and this positive deficiency khatam ho gayi. Okay, and now deficiency will be here, isn't it? So let the positive charge develop over here, and this bond I have not touched anything, so it will be remain like this. Yes, next again the anti-clockwise direction movement, and this bond will shift over here. Or ye movement tab tak hota rahega once we will getting the first previous structure. Okay, so if I am drawing like this, what we will get? The structure like this I have not touched, so make it like this. Here double bond, and here it is plus charge. What next? This bond will shift over here, and it will give you the structure like this. The bond over here, and this is positive charge will be developed over here. Yes, positive charge over developed. I have not touched this, so it will remain like this. What next? This bond will shift over here, and we will get our structure back. I think yes, you see. This is going to form the bond over here. Yes, this is going to form the bond over here. I have not touched this, so let it be. And now shifting, due to shifting of this bond here, the positive charge will develop, so we'll get this positive charge. So we got the first structure. So how many canonical structure? They are the this one. We'll not consider this. Okay, why? Because it is same. So one only we will say. Here you can say that why I have not considered this and this as the same, because you can see 1 and 2 ke beech mein bond hai, and here 1 and 6 ke beech mein bond hai. But if you see this, it is exactly same, isn't it? So that's why it will not be included, only one. So here it is, 5 canonical structure. I hope all this resonance is clear. One more class will be there for this resonance practice, and there we will do our rest 3 tricks. So 3 tricks we have done, 3 tricks in that next video. So till then class, just go through the video properly and make short notes. Enjoy your study. We'll meet you in next video. Till then, thank you class.